Hey everyone, here's another machine by request, a Kenmore Progressive bagless vac. I've had this machine for many years now. At first, when I seen the request, as usual, my first thought was, have I ran this machine before? Maybe they're mistaken. You know, just to make sure that I'm not going to be repeating unnecessary videos of some sort. And then I thought about it, I'm like, you know what? Yeah, they're probably right, because I had this machine long before this Vac Master the Great channel was conceived. And this machine was given to me by a longtime friend who I call family. Kind of funny story behind it, actually, and probably the reason that he was able to get it. Him and his brothers were out riding their bikes in their neighborhood one day, years ago this was, of course. And, of course, I believe they seen this and a Eureka the Boss stick vac that I should still have. I don't recall where. But anyway, they've seen both of these, and he somehow convinced his younger brother to carry the nice heavy upright home while he took the stick vac. And then, of course gave it to me because that's what he picked it for. That's the funny part of the story is he had his brother drag the thing home for me. So what ended up being wrong with it, it was in very nice shape, except for the cord being chopped and all the attachments with it. I'm pretty certain the people neglected to read their owner's manual and repeatedly used the brush shut off, as seen there, without shutting the machine off. Well, but you don't know anything about how these ones work, and I don't know off the top of my head any other machine that uses this kind of odd style of brush engagement. What it does is basically all it is an arm that sits between the belt. So you got, okay, I guess that's the best way to look at it. Okay, looking at this side of the machine, this is the motor pulley, and the belt goes around the motor pulley, and this arm sits in between. Here's the belt. This thing sits in between the belt. And what it does is when engaged in carpet, it sits in between so the belt can spin around the motor pulley. Then when not engaged, it picks up on the top part of the belt and pulls it up and back above the motor pulley so it no longer engages it. Well, any common sense of this thing would make sense that spinning at whatever thousands of RPMs this motor is turning that belt at, picking up on it with a metal or plastic, I believe it's metal lever at such speed is going to wear that rubber belt out pretty quick. And then, of course, grabbing it and dropping it back again on that spinning motor pulley to re-engage the brush roll is also going to wear the belt out pretty quickly. Sense why in the owner's manual it says shut the machine off before engaging or disengaging the belt, which in itself is a dumb idea that you have to shut the thing off if you want to shut the brush roll off. Plenty of other companies found easier ways around that. Having a brush on and off system. But anyway, so that was probably the reason they threw it out, was because this thing looked like they had chewed up at least four or five belts in it before giving up. So, that was my reasonable. At first, I thought it was there was something wrong with the brush roll, but I mean, the brush roll was in great shape. And then I thought about it, I'm like, hey, but then I seen how much belt was caked on that lever system. Well, yeah, someone was probably just dumb enough to not realize their mess up. So, this thing was, I would, of course, love to have the bagged version instead of bagless. It would probably get more use in that regard. The filter is kind of a pain to clean on this quick clean style machine. And also, it sits in the back. It's behind several machines, so most machines that sit behind several machines don't get pulled out for general use. Anyway, that all said, that little story aside, I'll give her a run now. So, there we have the Kenmore Progressive, the bagless upright. Hope you enjoyed it.